Hey everyone, it's Justin again. In science, finance, and a bunch of other areas, it's super important to know how quickly values are increasing in order to predict future changes. So in this video, we're going to learn how to tell the difference between linear growth and exponential growth. We'll be talking about slope a lot, so review your notes on slope if you ever get confused. This data shows a function growing linearly. We know it's linear because the slope is constant. For every interval, the slope is 3/1. Even if some values are missing, the data we do have will still carry that same slope. If the data has a constant slope, it's linear. This data is very clearly not linear. The slope keeps getting higher and higher, but I think I see a pattern here. The slope keeps doubling. This is how we can recognize exponential growth. The slopes are not constant, but rather have a common ratio, just like when we learned about sequences. Exponential data can also be incomplete, but now we can't ignore that skip like we do with linear functions. If we tried that, it looks like there's no pattern at all. Instead, we have to pretend we know the missing data and test whether the common ratio pattern could still pass through that empty space. If we assume that the slope doubled here, 2/6, and then doubled again, 2/12, we end up right back on track with this pattern, doubling the slope to 24 next, as if that line of data hadn't been missing at all. Let's test some data. Does this data seem to be growing linearly or exponentially? First, let's find the slope between every two consecutive points. From -2, 1 to -1, 4, the slope is 3/1. Between that point and the next, the y increases by 12 and the x increases by 1. So this definitely isn't linear because the slope changes, but could it be exponential? For it to be exponential, there needs to be a common ratio between the slopes. Between 3 and 12, the ratio is 4. So what's the next slope? From 0/16 to 1/64, the slope is 48/1. It's not the same as the other slopes, but it does follow that ratio of multiplying the previous slope by 4. This is definitely looking exponential, but let's finish with the last slope. 192/1. That's a really steep slope. And guess what? 192 is 48 times 4, which means we have a confirmed common ratio. This data is growing exponentially. Let's do another one, and this time, there's some data missing. First, we check for a constant slope. Between the first two points, the slope is 8. Between 8/10 and 9/50, the slope is 40. It's pretty clear this isn't going to be linear, so let's check for a common ratio. Between the first two slopes, the ratio is 5. The missing data point means that we need to continue the ratio and see if it picks back up with the data afterwards. If the ratio stays 5, then the next slope will be 200/1. So the missing point would be 10/50. And then multiplying that slope by 5 would then give a slope of 1,000, which would make the next point way higher than just 400. So a ratio of 5 does not work for this whole data set. This data doesn't have a constant slope nor a common ratio between its slopes. So this data is neither linear nor exponential. All right, now it's your turn. Pause the video and see if you can identify whether this data grows linearly or exponentially. What type of growth do you think this is? Hopefully, the first thing you notice is that we're missing a data point where x would be -2. Let's look for a common slope. If the data has a common slope, then missing values can be ignored. Between -3, -4, and -1, 0, the slope is 4/2, which reduces to 2. Between the next two points, the slope is 2, and again between the last two points. The slope is the same for all the data, so this data is growing linearly. It's important to know whether data is growing in a straight line or exponentially. And the way to tell is by checking the slopes. Either the slope is the same for all the data, or it gets steeper and steeper by the same ratio. In the next lesson, we're going to continue comparing linear and exponential growth by looking at their graphs. See you then.